for another hour of meditating together. And so allowing yourself once again to just be present, be here, be in this space, be in this room. Being in your body, on your seat, not somewhere else. Knowing what is going on. Knowing what is going on in your body, what is going on in your mind. Remembering, we're learning to get out of the way. We're learning in meditation to not be the one in charge. We're learning to be a passenger on the bus. So we have been talking, Ajahn Mali has been talking about remembering our death. How many times we have died. How many times we have been perhaps sitting together practicing like this. Imagine how hard we have tried many, many lifetimes ago to go through school, to go through teenage years, to get somewhere in life, see our families finally succeed or not, see them go up and down in their lives. And then finally, it all ends. And then we start again. Again. Go going through school, going through teenage years, trying so hard to get somewhere in life, building up a career, seeing our families go up and down in life. And then it ends. And again, we are born, we go to school, we go through teenage years, we try so hard to get somewhere in life, build up a career, see our families go up and down in life. And then it ends. And imagine in 10,000 lifetimes you see yourself being born, going to school, becoming a teenager, trying so hard to get somewhere in life, seeing our families go up and down, their successes and failures, and it all ends. And in 20,000 lifetimes, we see ourselves again, being born, going to school, going through teenage years, trying so hard to get somewhere in life, seeing our families go up and down in life, and then it ends. And seeing ourselves in 10 million lives, again, going to school, going through teenage years, trying so hard to get somewhere in life, seeing our families go up and down, and it comes to an end. And so it will go on. Imagine being alive in another 10 million lives doing the same thing again. With the enthusiasm that we have in this life, in 10 million lives, applying ourselves with the same enthusiasm to get on in life. Going endlessly on into the future. Endlessly on from the past. Doing the same thing. Thinking that we are getting somewhere. Trying to be someone, trying to find the security, trying to make our lives just right every time. Seeing how it feels. What do you feel when you see yourself doing this over and over again? You feel you've had enough. Does the mind want to give up? Give up trying? Give up trying to create something? Maybe your mind is happy just to be. Just to be okay with things just as they are. Stepping out of the way. Not being so invested in success or failure. In even our meditation going right. And so in different ways like this, we use the Dhamma to see how things never quite work out. They're trying endlessly. It works for a while, and then it ends. Reflecting on your own life, when you thought you had the perfect partner, got the perfect house, how it's never quite been perfect forevermore. So, in your own way, noticing how you can, how your mind turns away turns away from the world, turns away from finding the tortoise with the moustache. Looking for the sweet chili, as Nasruddin says. You know the story? Eternally looking for the sweet chili. Notice, if you do, the relief of giving up. The relief of knowing that it's not about you. It's not about trying. We see the pleasure in giving up, in not controlling. So you can reflect in this way, or just continue to sit for the next 45 minutes, allowing, noticing what leads to peace, what leads to letting go. What is true happiness? going on to your usual object of meditation, with hopefully a mind that is less controlling, less invested. end of the meditation, again, and just spending a few minutes to reflect, seeing how things changed, because they did. Once again, before we end, dedicating the merit of our practice to all beings. May the peace in our minds, may it somehow pervade and touch the lives of all beings on this planet. Beings find peace in their lives. May they find the true cause of happiness and live in ease and at peace. When you're ready, you can slowly open your eyes.